Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Our speaker today is Sheikh Misbah Omar Idruss. Sheikh Misbah has studied at the International University of Africa in Sudan and is currently a teacher at the adult Madressah classes at the Institute for Islamic Services. His topic today is backbiting and its consequences in Islam.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والمسلمين أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن الكريم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا فكرهتموه واتقوا الله إن الله التواب الرحيم وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم إياكم والغيبة أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. O praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all universe. I bear witness that there is none worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his messenger. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless him and also to bless his family members, his sahabas, and all Muslim ummah to the day of judgment. My respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, insha'Allah ta'ala, I'll be talking about backbiting and also slandering and its dangers. As we all know that nowadays these two are so widespread that they became the topic of people's meetings and avenues for expressing their anger, misgiving, and jealousy. So I try to divide this topic into four sections. I'll speak about the definition of al-ghiba, backbiting. And also I'll speak about the forms of backbiting. And also I'll speak about the ruling regarding backbiting, and also the dangers of backbiting, and also when backbiting is allowed, and how to repent from backbiting. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, to begin with, let us know what backbiting really means. I'm going to give you the definition from my master and your master, my teacher and your teacher, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is narrated in the hadith hadith that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once asked his companions by saying, Atadruna mal ghiba? Do you know what backbiting is? Qalu Allahu wa rasuluhu a'lam. They replied by saying, Allah and His Messenger knows best. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-ghiba dhikruka akhaka bima yakra. When we are talking about backbiting, it is to say something about your brother in his absence that would dislike him. To say something about your brother in his absence that will dislike him. Qila, ara'aita in kana fi akhi ma aqul? Someone asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, but what if what I said is true? But what if what I said is true? Is it gonna be backbiting? Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in kana fihi ma taqul faqad ightabtahu. If what you say about him is true, then really you have backbeaten him. وَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ فِيهِ مَا تَقُولُ وَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ فِيهِ فَقَدْ بَهَتَّهُ. But if it is not true what you are saying about your brother, then you have slandered him. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, these are the meanings of backbiting and slandering. These two things, when we do these two things, backbiting and slandering, we must know that at the same time, we are oppressing our brother. And the ulama further explained to us that this backbiting and slandering can be done either by speaking ill about our brother, by speaking ill about our brother's nature, the way how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him, his nature. Maybe he is short, or he is tall, or he is fat, or he is thin. Or maybe he got a problem. He got one arm, or one leg. Speaking about his nature, or speaking about his character. Maybe he steals, he's a thief. Maybe he talks too much. Maybe he likes women. Maybe many things that he does, which is bad. Then speaking about his character. And also it can be speaking about his weaknesses in deen. Speaking about his weaknesses in deen. For example, maybe he don't pray. Maybe he don't recite Quran nicely. He don't pay zakah. He don't respect people. All those things is under backbiting. It can be speaking about his economic weaknesses. Maybe he don't have money, he's poor. The way how he dress. It can be also speaking about his parents' weaknesses. The ulamas, they continued to say it can also done through any form of communication. Backbiting and slandering can be done through any form of communication. Qala al-Imam al-Ghazali fi kitabihi Ihya ulumuddin, volume 3, page 142. Imam al-Ghazali said in his book, kullu ma yufhim al-maqsood فَهُوَ دَاخِلُ فِي الْغِيبَ وَهُوَ حَرَامٌ. Any form of communication which used to backbite is haram. It can be email. It can be any instant messaging. It can be a phone call. even sign language. We can use sign language to backbite. My respected brothers and sisters, we are talking about backbiting and slandering. Also, we can use, for example, maybe somebody, the way how he walk, he doesn't walk nicely. Then we want to backbite him. If we fall the way how he walk, it can be under backbiting. It is also haram. The way how somebody speaks, the way how somebody looks, if we show people like the way how he do it, so that we may degrade him, it is also a form of backbiting. My respected brothers and sisters, sign language can be backbiting. We can backbite with our eyes. We can backbite with our hands. We can backbite with our legs. Any form of communication can be used in backbiting. It is reported in the hadith that Aisha radiallahu anha, the wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wanted a lady who was short, went to the Prophet's house, and by the time she was going out, Aisha, she showed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the sign that that lady is too short. فَأَوْبَعَتْ يَدَهَا. She showed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the sign to show that that lady is short. فَقَالَ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said لِعَائِشَ to Aisha, فَقَدْ غِتَبْتِيهِ. You have backbited her. My respected brothers and sisters, all these are haram. Allah said in the Holy Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا. Do not backbite one another. أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا. Would one of you like to eat the flesh of his dead brother? فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ. You would hate it. If you would hate to eat the flesh of your dead brother, so hate backbiting. Because backbiting is like to eat the meat of your dead brother. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the ulama said, the meaning of this verse in another way is أَنَّهُ كَمَا لَا يَحِلُّ لَحْمُهُ حَيًّا وَمَيِّتًا كَذَلِكَ لَا تَحِلُّ غَيْبَتُهُ حَيًّا وَلَا مَيِّتًا. As it is not halal to eat his meat while he is alive or dead, it is also haram to backbite him while he is alive, also while he is dead. And Allah continues by saying, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. If he was backbiting, then fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by stopping backbiting. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, stop backbiting. إِنَّ اللَّهَ. And you must know that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, تَوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ, is one who forgives and accepts repentance. قال القرطبي في كتابه أحكام القرآن. Imam Qurtubi said in his book أحكام القرآن, he said about backbiting, لا خلاف أن الغيبة من الكبائر وأن من اغتاب أحدا عليه أن يتوب إلى الله عز وجل. He said there is no argument that backbiting is one of the big sins. And if a person backbites, he must repent and come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, backbiting is the most dangerous product among all the products that the tongue, the mouth produces. And it is the common dangerous disease among us. The disease that when it infects the community, the society, it creates enmity and it destroys good deeds. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his popular hadith, يُؤْتَى بِأَحَدٍ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَيُوْقَفْ بَيْنَ يَدَيْ رَبِّ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. A person shall be brought in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. وَيُدْفَعْ إِلَيْهِ كِتَابُهُ. And his book will be handed over to him, meaning the book of his deeds. فَلَا يَرَى حَسَنَاتِهِ فِيهِ. He will not see any good deeds in it. فَيَقُولُ. And he shall say, إِلَهِ. Oh my Lord, لَيْسَ هَذَا كِتَابِي. This is not my book. لَا أَرَى فِيهِ حَسَنَاتِ. I can't see my good deeds in this book. فَيُقَالُ لَهُ. And it shall be said to him, إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَا يَذِلُّ وَلَا يَنْسَى. Verily, your Lord does not make mistakes and he doesn't forget. As it is said in the Holy Quran, وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ نَسِيًّا. Your Lord was not, cannot, and he will never forget. And it will be said to him, ذَهَبَ عَمَلُكَ بِخْتِيَابِ النَّاسِ. Your good deeds are gone because you was backbiting people. Your good deeds is taken from you, and Allah awarded those people who you was backbiting. ثُمَّ يُؤْتَى بِآخَرِ وَيُدْفَعُ إِلَيْهِ كِتَابُهُ فَيَرَى فِيهِ طَاعَاتِ كَثِيرًا. Then another person shall be brought and handed over his book full of good deeds. And he shall say, إِلَهِ. Oh my Lord, مَا هَذَا كِتَابِي. This is not my book. فَإِنِّي مَا عَمِلْتُ هَذِهِ الطَّاعَاتِ. Because I did not perform all these deeds. Because the day of judgment, no one will lie in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this person will say, this is not my book because I didn't perform all these deeds. فَيُقَالُ لَهُ. And it shall be said to him, إِنَّ فُلَانًا إِغْتَابَكَ فَدُفِعَ حَسَنَاتُهُ إِلَيْكَ. So and so backbited you, so their good deeds have been awarded to you. Subhanallah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, these are the dangers of backbiting. There are many dangers of backbiting. I cannot mention all of them now because of time. My respected brothers and sisters, because of time, how can we repent from backbiting? How can a person repent from backbiting? A person can repent from backbiting by following three conditions. As it is said that the first condition is to regret that what you have done was wrong, is haram. The second one is to be sincere. To regret and be sincere, and also to stop doing something which is bad, to stop backbiting, and also to not do it again. My respected brothers and sisters, and the ulama continues by saying, if you want to repent from backbiting, it doesn't stop there. You have to go to that person who you have backbited, then ask him to forgive you. If you do that, Allah will forgive you. But if you feel that if you go to that person, it will cause another harm, the ulama says that you have to make dua for that person, you have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive that person, and you have to speak good about that person in front of those people whom you was with by the time you was backbiting that person. You have to say, guys, this person, the one I was backbiting, I realized now that this guy is a good guy. He does this, this, and this, which is good. You have to talk in front of those people, but you mustn't lie. If you do that, it is sufficient for you. Inshallah, Allah will forgive you. My respected brothers and sisters, there is many things to talk about backbiting. But because of time, we cannot speak, we cannot talk all of those things now. أقول قول هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم إنه هو الغفور الرحيم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
أيها المؤمنون بتقواه وأن تقولوا قولا سديدا مستقيما عدلا ووعدكم على ذلك إصلاح أعمالكم ومغفرة ذنوبكم أيها المؤمنون إن من نعم الله العظيمة ولطائف صنعه البديعة هذا اللسان الذي به تتكلمون وتنطقون عما في قلوبكم أو أنفسكم تعرضون فإن لسان المرء مفتاح قلبه إذا هو أبدى ما يقول من الفم أيها المؤمنون إن اللسان من نعم الله الجليلة التي امتن الله بها عليكم لتشكروه وتعبدوه قال تعالى أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ألم نجعل له عينين ولسانا وشفتين وقال سبحانه وتعالى الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان فبه يتمايز الكفر من الإيمان ويفترق أولياء الرحمن عن أولياء الشيطان به يبلغ العبد وأعرف الجنان وبه يهوى في دركات النيران وفي الصحيحين من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن العبد ليتكلم بكلمة ما يتبين فيها يزل بها إلى النار أبعد ما بين المشرق والمغرب وفي رواية البخاري إن العبد يتكلم بكلمة من رضوان الله لا يلقى لها بالا يرفعه الله بها درجات في الجنة وإن العبد ليتكلم بكلمة من سخط الله تعالى لا يلقى لها بالا يهوي بها في نار جهنم فاتقوا الله عباد الله واحذروا ألسنتكم فإنها من أعظم ما يوقعكم في أسباب الهلاك واحفظوها فإن حفظها من أسباب الفوز والنجاة فقد تكفر صلى الله عليه وسلم لمن حفظ لسانه أو صان منطقه بالجنة دار السلام ففي الصحيح من حديث سهل بن سعد رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من يضمن لي ما بين لحييه وما بين رجليه أضمن له الجنة أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله أستعينه وأستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعصيهما فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى علي واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين أئمة الحنفاء أبو بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وفاطمة سيدة النساء أهل الجنة والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله اللهم اغفر العباس وولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبا الله في أصحابي لا تتخذوهم غرضا من بعدي فمن أبغضهم فببغضي أبغضهم ومن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم لا تزع قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى، نسألك فعل الخيرات وترك المنكرات وترك الغيبة يا رب العالمين. اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. عباد الله، إن الله يأمركم بثلاثة وينهاكم بثلاثة، يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهاكم عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروه يذكركم واشكروه ولا تكفرون. أقيموا الصلاة، إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا مرقوما.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا السلام عليكم.